What's the best way to spice up your sex life? Take a stripping class from Brooke Burns. An all-new Rock Me Baby, coming up next on UPN. From Blushing Bride.
This whole bride thing is even more fabulous than I imagined.
To Bridezilla.
These people can't get enough of me.
Girlfriends on a special night. UPN tonight after Rock Me Baby.
Happy anniversary.
Thank you. We really need to do a load of dishes.
All right. I want you to open your present first. Oh, okay. I put a lot of thought into it.
Okay. Uh-oh. Let's see.
It's a homemade Daddy and Otis memory book. Oh. I put pages in for each of his major milestones. His first tooth. The first time he rolled over. And his first Halloween.
Oh, it was the cutest Freddy Krueger ever. Little razor blade fingernails. This is great, honey. Thank you so much. You must have worked forever on this. God, thank you. Mm-hmm. You know, I hope you like mine as much as I like yours. Matching undies are edible, and if you read the label, kosher. Why'd you go try them on?
Oh, babe, maybe in a little while.
Well, in a little while, they might spoil. You would love this.
I do. It's just, it's been a really long day. You know, I got up early, and Otis was fussy. To top it all off, I think we need baby proofing.
Oh, hey, I got some. I picked up some happy anniversary condoms. Yeah, well, at first they just say happy, but eventually they say anniversary. Or maybe just Ann.
No, I mean, we need a baby-proofing expert to come by and check out the apartment. Otis pulled on a cord and almost pulled a lamp down on himself today.
My Bronco lamp? I mean, I'm glad Otis didn't get hurt.
I know we're gonna have a good time, yeah.
I checked out the whole place, and it's a good thing you called. I'd say your baby will be lucky if he makes it to 5 months.
But he's already 6 months.
Like I said, lucky.
You know, the place seems pretty safe to me.
Is that right? Listen, if you want to see the dangers, you got to get down to the baby's level. Come on down here. Come on down here with me. Now, do you see all the hidden dangers? Like this table, for instance? Seems perfectly harmless, right? Wrong.
Ouch, didn't that hurt?
Nah, the old metal plate protected me. Come on into the kitchen, AKA the dungeon of death. Now, what your baby's gonna do, see, is open up this cupboard and look. He's got a ladder. So he can climb up onto the counter, grab one of these big knives. After he's finished killing the family dog, he moves on. And what's the first thing he sees? A big, friendly blender. Oh, look at all those pretty buttons. Maybe I'll have a flesh and bone shake.
We get the idea. I'll tell you what. Here's your clipboard. There you go. We'll give you a call. We'll think about it.
Sure?
And, yeah, we'll let you know. Okay?
You got my number and everything.
Great. Well, we're going to have to do this ourselves, which means I'm going to have to do it myself, because God knows you're not too handy.
Well, hey, who put Otis's crib together?
The delivery guy.
Yes, but who paid him and gave him a Diet Coke?
Well, this should make for a fun weekend.
Hey, listen, how about this? Sunday, we'll baby-proof the house. Saturday, I'll take Otis all day. You have the day off to do whatever you want. Go to spa or something.
Really?
Yeah.
That does sound nice. Are you sure?
Absolutely. You know what? Consider it my real anniversary gift, okay? The body floss will say for my birthday.
Hey, Kevin, don't we have a stripper teacher on today?
Yeah, she's out in the lobby.
Well, then why aren't you wearing your t-shirt that says sex instructor, first lesson free?
What's the use? No one ever takes me up on it anyway. I'm just a fat, pathetic loser.
I'm starting to think Kevin's depressed.
Okay, we're back on the Jimmy and Carl Show on the Core.
Joining us today is Aaron Rimzing, owner of the Mile High Dance Studio, which is a school that teaches the art of exotic dance. Welcome, Aaron. Welcome.
Thanks, guys. Welcome. Good to be here.
Yes. Okay, Aaron, why don't you explain your job for us?
Well, in layman's terms... Layman. Basically, what I do is teach women how to perform striptease.
Oh, well, that's you know it. What? Yeah. Yeah. On behalf of the entire community, thank you. Thanks.
Yes. Yes, Roger, you're doing the Lord's work, girl.
So, now, what qualifies you to teach this class?
Well, I have 15 years' experience in the art of exotic dance. And I'm a college graduate.
College graduate? Yeah, what kind of degree is that? A Ph. Double D?
Yeah, what do you call a stripper college? Is that SNMU?
No, Texas T&A NM.
Oh.
Would you like to hear our fight thong? Our mascot was a Japanese businessman.
Wow, you have a lot more of these than we do.
Well, I've been doing this for a while.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so what's this class really about? Mm-hmm.
It's about empowerment. You know, we get a lot of women and occasionally some men, actually, who come in and they don't feel that good about themselves. Maybe they're a little overweight. But after one workout, they feel stronger, more self-confident, and sexier.
Sexier? Sexier, huh? You know, maybe I should sign my wife up for the class. This has been a test of the emergency foot and mouth system.
Believe that? A stripper school?
Why does he think you need to take the class?
Oh, well, maybe because we didn't have sex on our anniversary.
Really? Well, even I had sex on your anniversary.
Well, I wasn't in the mood. I can't just put on a piece of new lingerie and feel sexy.
You know, Beth, you complain about being tired and stressed and not feeling sexy, but what are you doing to spice things up? I mean, at least Jimmy's trying. He bought you beautiful string lingerie and delicious kosher underwear. Mmm. Mazel tov.
I'm not going to take a stripper class.
Oh, yes, you are. And we're going to do it together.
Why do you want to take it, Pam?
Well, it's just like the lady said. I want to get in touch with my girl power. Besides, there is nothing sexier than stripping in front of a bunch of strangers. Or people you know. Ah, oh, hell, I guess the key here is just getting naked.
Hey.
Hey.
What's up?
Where's Pam?
What do you mean?
You said she was waiting for me?
Yeah.
I lied.
But listen, now that you're here, you can help me baby-proof the place, okay?
Dude, I can't believe you did this to me. It's my day off. I could be at home watching Animal Planet. It's Weasel Week.
Come on, Carl, I need your help. Look, Beth's really been stressed out lately, and she went to a spa for the day, so I want to surprise her by doing this.
All right, fine. If I do this, I get your Bronco leg.
My Bronco... All right, fine. It's yours.
All right. What are you doing?
I don't know. That's what guys do when they wear a tool belt.
Okay. All right, fine. Let's make the place safe for the babies. Making the place safe, looking. Oh! Bronco lamp?
Good morning, class. I'm your instructor, Aaron, or as I'm known when I'm dancing, White Chocolate.
Good morning, White Chocolate.
Thank you. Now, the goal of this class is to make each one of you feel stronger. That means mentally, spiritually, and physically. So I want you all to relax and know that we're all here to support each other. Also know that whatever happens in this class stays in this class, okay?
Good, because I do not want anyone knowing I'm taking a stripper class.
You are not gonna believe who's here, dude.
And one, and two.
Kevin, I don't know why you're here, but I don't want anyone to know I'm taking this class.
Oh, hey, that's cool. I can keep a secret.
I mean, it's been 3 years since Jimmy purposely lost that scarf you made him.
He did?
Nope.
All right, class, now I see a couple of new faces, so what I want to do is have you come up and introduce yourselves and say why you're taking the class. Let's see who wants to go first. Okay, how about you?
Well, hello, my name is Pam, but my stripper name is Pam Demonium. And I'm here because I got the package. I just want to learn how to deliver it. Okay. And? How about you?
Hey, my name's Kevin. My stripper name is Krispy Kreme. They call me that because I'm round and sweet and empty inside.
I'd just like to say that it's always nice to have a man in the class. Thanks for being here. And, who are you?
Oh, me. Okay. Hi. I'm Beth. My stripper name is... Crispy Beth. And, I guess I'm taking this class because ever since I became a mother, well, I haven't really felt very good about my body, so I'd like to feel sexier. You know, just a couple of days ago, it was our anniversary, and I wasn't in the mood, and then my best friend ate my underwear, and... Yeah, can we just start?
Okay. Allison. This is my assistant, Allison. She's going to be demonstrating some of the moves that you guys will be learning today in class. Go ahead.
All right, ladies and Krispy Kreme. This first move is called the twirling helicopter.
Great. Thank you, Allison. So, which one of you would like to try that move first?
Oh.
Let's see.
Oh,
Beth, how about you?
Oh, didn't you see I was looking away?
Okay, anyone else?
Pam Demonium.
Okay. Hit it.
That's the advantage of dating a fireman.
All right, the door is latched and baby-proofed. You know what? I gotta tell you something. This whole do-it-yourself thing, it's very empowering. I like holding a tool in my hand.
Do I even have to make the joke?
You know, I never thought I'd be into this whole handyman.
What, you kidding me? Being a handyman is like one of my top five fantasies.
Oh, yeah?
I'm working my way through Harvard, walking past this sorority, right, when a bunch of co-eds yell out at me, "Yoo-hoo, handsy man, could you help us with our leaky faucet?"
Dude, there are so many things wrong with that fantasy, beginning with, how did you get into Harvard?
I forgot to mention, I'm a Kennedy.
Ah. Don't worry, Otis, Daddy's coming. Oh, son of a... Put the latch on the wrong side. Oh, great. We're locked in.
How do you know?
I'm holding the knob in my hand.
Do I even need to make the joke?
Thank you, Professor Chocolate. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to tend to my pole burn.
All right. Okay, next up, Cricket, how about you?
Kevin. I assumed you were here to pick up women, but you're not wearing your sex instructor t-shirt.
So why are you here?
Ah, well, pretty much the same reason as you, I guess.
You don't feel sexy after you had your baby?
Ever since Kate blew me off, my self-esteem's taken a total hit. Maybe that's because I'm a loser.
Oh, Kevin. You are great. You're funny and outgoing.
Thanks. That means a lot coming from you. I mean, you're like this great wife and mom, and you're the hottest woman I've ever talked to without being slapped or entering a credit card number.
Thanks, Kevin. That is so sweet.
Great. Great job, Cricket. Thank you. Okay. Who's next?
I want to try.
Right. Yeah. You go, girl.
People still say that, right?
Everybody give it up for Crispy Beth.
See you, babe.
Oh, God.
Let's make this a duo.
This is the part in my recurring dream where I fall to my death.
Okay. Just a dream. You're okay. You're safe.
There we go. Oh, damn, my baby proofing expertise.
Okay, Otis. Don't worry, buddy. Daddy's coming.
Come on over here and open the window.
Get in here.
Took the door off the hinges.
Well, pull me through here.
All right. Can you help me out, all right?
Yeah.
Push. Oh. Push. Come on, come on, push. Oh. Push. Come on.
You look familiar, buddy?
Huh?
What you look like coming out of mommy 6 months ago.
Come on.
Hi.
Hey, hi. So how was your day off?
I feel like a new woman.
Yeah?
Mm, it was so nice to have the afternoon to myself. How is Otis today?
Pretty good. He's taking a nap.
Yeah?
Although I think he's stealing our silverware, so I put latches on everything.
You baby-proofed the house?
Darn tootin' fig Newton. Although the bedroom still needs a few tweaks.
I can't believe you did all this.
So you're not gonna say anything about the broken window or the door?
No. You were so sweet today, I'm not going to say anything until I need to use it against you.
Well, I wanted to give you a break. I mean, even though you take care of Otis in the house all day, I don't think you realize how hard it is to take care of Otis in the house all day. Man, I'm exhausted. You know, now I understand why you're not in the mood some nights.
Oh, it's too bad you're not in the mood, because I learned some new moves at the, spa.
Was there a cover charge at the spa?
Oh, well, actually, I didn't go to the spa. I went to stripper class. Yeah, I heard about it on your show, and I took the class, and I'm feeling much better about myself.
Well, I'm starting to feel much better about myself, too. Carl, my wife is amazing. I mean, how many wives would take a stripper course and then invite one of her classmates to come in and strip for us, huh?
Yeah.
But that's the kind of woman that Beth is, see? Yeah. She's the kind of woman
Jimmy,
that would...
let's talk. More strippers.
Sorry, honey, please.
All right, boys.
Yes.
I'd like you to put your hands together for the super hot, the super sexy, Krispy Kreme!
Superstar Tuesday.
Woo! Jessica Alba in the house.
Beautiful guest stars are great.
I'm in no hurry to get home if you are.
But a hot wife is even better.
I got all worried and jealous for nothing.
And I think we finally settled the debate over who your daddy is once and for all.
An all-new Rocky Baby. At a special time, UPN next Tuesday.